let's start out with the good hip bounce. Hip bounce. Bouncing while loosening up our hips, giving a twist. Using this warm up to start focusing on our breath, getting the blood flowing, loosening up our body. This is more of a mobility, so there'll be similar movements as there are in our HIIT classes, but more of the mobility and really using the minute to go at your own pace. Standing, knee to chest, we'll alternate sides.
Two, one, go.
And go. Really focused on staying stable throughout the whole movement, bringing the knee up as high as we can, grabbing with two hands and giving it an extra pull. Again, we're exhaling as we go into a stretch. Trying to stay nice and tall. Good posture as we're bringing the knee to our chest. We're as high as we can go.
Three, two, one, rest.
Good. Next one, we'll bring our feet to our opposite hand.
Three, two, one, go.
And give it an extra pull. And right here. There you go, we're gonna try and stay on balance. Our right side's off today. It's not off, I just gotta improve it, right? That's okay. Focus on our breathing. Find the balance. Shoulder complexes, okay?
Three, two, one, go.
We're gonna start hands straight out, palms up. Exhale as we open up. At 30 seconds, we're gonna bring our elbows into our side at a 90 degree angle, palms still staying up. And we're here. Opening up the chest, keeping our elbows by our side. Warm up. So hip rotation is going to the right.
Three, two, one, go.
Let's go. At 45 seconds, we'll go to the left. Switch directions. At 30 seconds, we'll bring our legs together and we're gonna rotate at our knees. Legs together, rotating to the right. Seconds, we'll switch directions, going to the left, and switch.
3, 2, 1, rest.
Good. All right, let's get into our stand-up movements. Right leg's going to be forward, we're going to do it in a toe line step.
3, 2, 1, go.
And go. Nice athletic stance. Right foot's always in front. As we step forward, it's our front foot that's leading. As we step back, it's the back foot. Staying in a nice athletic stance. Breathing as we move, having it all be in sync. Ten seconds. Left legs forward.
3, 2, 1, go.
Then go. Our back foot, guys, we want to stay on the ball of our foot. So our heel's up the whole time on the back foot. So nice and balanced. Give it 10 seconds.
Rest.
Good. Nice. Next move, we're going to do a standing arm drag.
3, 2,
pulling across the right side first.
Go.
Here we go. We're going to step out with the left. Pull across with our right. Pull across our body. Look into where we're pulling. Again, step out with the left, pull across our body, and back. Nice and balanced. We're putting the weight on our left leg as we look across our body. Pulling, engaging our lats on our right side as we pull across, just like a row. Exhaling as we pull. 10 seconds. Weight now is in our right leg as we pull and look to our left. We're reaching across our body, pulling across our body. Exhaling as we pull. Remember, we're exhaling as we exert energy. And we exhale as we go into our stretch. So feel your body where throughout the exercise you're exerting the most energy. 10 seconds. That's where we're exhaling, recovering as we inhale.
3, 2, 1, rest.
Good. All right, guys, now we're going into a standing, a sprawling hold. Okay, right leg will be forward.
1, go.
So again, we're gonna go back. Our front foot is gonna go back first. As we bring it back, our left foot's gonna go up. We're gonna try and touch the floor with our right hand. Back foot together, front foot forward. Again. If you can't go back all the way, right here's okay, and balance. And here. And here. As you get more comfortable, you start elevating that back foot higher and higher and higher so we can touch. Seconds.
Three, two, one, rest.
Good. Switch sides, now the left. As you can tell, I don't do it perfectly every time. There's always room to grow and to get better every day. Right? Left leg now. Feel a nice stretch in your hamstring, the back of the leg that we're balancing on. Exhale, inhale, 10 seconds. First,
go.
We're going down. Both knees, standing back up with the right. Down with the right, up with the right. Control as we go down. Safe and nice to our knees. Standing up with some force. And we're working our lower body right now, so pay attention to what's happening with our upper body. Yeah, we want to be nice and relaxed. 10 seconds. Our whole body relaxed. So feeling your shoulders are tense, tight, relaxed. Good. Last one standing, we're gonna go down with our left, step up with our left.
3, 2, 1, go.
And begin. Nice and controlled. Exhale as we go down, exhale as we come up. Good, 10 seconds.
Three.
Nice. Good, guys. All right, now we're going down to the ground. We're going to start out with a hollow body roll. So we're in a seated guard position here. We're going to tuck our chin. We're going to hollow our spine. And we're going to roll. Come back. Loosening up the spine. So the breathing, we can exhale as we roll. Inhale, exhale. So we're exhaling as we're rolling on the spine. Two inhales in between. Chin tucked as we roll back. We want to stay off our neck. We're rolling onto our shoulders.
Rest.
Good. Now we're going to straighten one leg. It's going to be our pendulum leg. Right? It's going to create force as we roll up. So we're going to start with the right leg. It's going to stay straight. As we roll forward, we're going to kick it up. Creating momentum to help us come forward. Left leg stays bent. As you get more comfortable, your right foot can start going back until it touches the floor behind our head. 30 seconds, we're gonna switch. Now it's our left leg that's straight. Also doing the pendulum leg. We go a little further back each time. Until our foot can touch the floor behind us. Less than 10 seconds. 5 seconds.
3, 2, 1. Rest.
Good. We're going to stay in a seated guard position. This is a seated guard position. Our feet are going to stay in the same place.
1, go.
We're here. We're going to drop both of our knees to the right. We're going to plant our right hand, we're going to look over our right shoulder. We're going to switch now, going to our left. Plant the left hand, drop the knees, and look over the left shoulder. And we're going back and forth. Opening up the hips. You should feel a nice stretch in the outside of your bottom hip. There's a vertical line at our hips. We want to think about keeping, as we're rotating from one side to the other, keeping our shoulders and head in front of that line. If we go behind 10 seconds, we're forced to engage our core more.
3, 2, 1, rest.
Good. Now we're going here, we're dropping. To the left, we're gonna lean our chest.
2, 1, go.
We're gonna lean our chest over our knee. It's gonna stay over our shin, and we're gonna rotate to our foot, back to our knee. Come up and switch sides. Dropping the chest over the knee, rotating to the foot, back to the knee. Going back and forth. Exhaling as we go into the stretch. Inhaling through the transition. To be able to transition back and forth easily, we're keeping our head and chest in front of our hips. 10 seconds. On here. So we're going to drop our knees to the same side. This time we're going to press up.
1, go.
Opening up that front hip and back down. Same original concept. Starting in a seated guard, dropping the knees, Now we're coming up and down. Driving that front hip forward. We have 10 seconds.
Three, two, one, rest.
Nice. All right, again, we're here in a seated guard position. This time we're gonna tuck our left foot towards our butt, use our left hand. We're gonna sit up, driving forward, okay? Again, seated guard. Tuck my left foot, plant my left hand, drive forward, my right knee's up. I'm gonna sit back down. We're staying on the same side. If you're comfortable with this movement, you can use no hands. So you're just tucking your left foot, driving forward. Again, we want to keep our chest, shoulders, and head moving forward. Ten seconds.
Three, two, one, rest.
Good. Now we're going to the right side. We're tucking our right foot, planting our right hand, driving forward, our left knee's up. Let's go. Really driving the hips forward. As we sit down, we're keeping our upper body forward. If we go back, we're here. If it's back, it's gonna be hard to stay up. So keeping the weight forward. Nice, guys. 10 seconds.
Three, two, one, rest.
Beautiful. Now we're going to do a self-defense stand-up. All right, so we're going to left hand, right foot. Right knee will be up. We're here. We're going to lift, and we're going to shift forward, extending our left leg. So we're balancing on our right foot, left hand, and back. Switch sides. Now I'm on my right hand, left foot. I'm gonna lift, I'm gonna shift forward, extend my leg, and back. We're extending and switching back and forth. Working both sides, working on our body coordination, control of our breathing, having it in sync with our body movements. Getting used to holding our body weight. This hand, our top hand, can either be used as a face guard here, where we'll be covering our face 10 seconds, our elbows higher than our hands, okay? Or it can be extended straight out,
three,
like we're grabbing something.
One, rest.
Good. Nice, guys, a few more exercises. We're gonna be on our back.
Three, two,
leg pummeling our legs.
Go.
So right leg's gonna go clockwise. Left leg's gonna go counterclockwise. We're gonna make big circles. Their hips, knees, and feet all being engaged. We're gonna get coordinated so we're not hitting our feet. We're gonna switch directions now. Excuse me, sorry, keep going the same way. At 30 seconds, we're switching. Right leg's still going clockwise, left leg's going counterclockwise. And switch. Now right leg is going to the left or counterclockwise. Our left leg is going clockwise or to the right. Seconds. Breathing.
3, 2, 1. Rest.
Good. One more set. So now, instead of circling, our legs are going to windshield wipe. Okay?
2, 1. Go.
Let's go. So our feet are going in the same direction, our knees are going in the same direction. And then we switch. Our foot should be tapping the inside of our opposite knee. At 30 seconds, we're going to extend our legs straight up into the air. Okay? So we're here, knees are at a 90, and we're going to extend straight back to a 90 and extend. So 10 seconds.
Three, 2, 1, rest.
Good. Now we're doing a Jiu Jitsu bridge. So we're going to be bridging over our right shoulder first, reaching with our left.
3, 2, 1, go.
As we bridge, we're looking to our right and reaching. Shin back. Big reach. Exhaling as we're reaching. Seconds.
3, 2, 1, rest.
Good. Let's go. Last exercise, bridging over our left shoulder. Jiu Jitsu bridge. Reaching with our right hand, looking where we're reaching.
Go.
Let's go. Last one. Let's go, 10 seconds. Give it all you got.
3, 2, 1, rest.
Good. Nice, guys. We have 2 minutes of breathing now. 2 minutes of breathing here, focusing on, as we exhale, we're drawing the belly button in, okay? Eyes closed, first minute is gonna be out of our mouth, okay? We're exhaling as we draw the belly button in. You can be in a seated position here or laying on your back, whatever's most comfortable, okay? 1 minute, starting now. Deep exhales. Good. This last minute of breathing, it'll be out of our nose. Once again, we're focused on the exhale, drawing the belly button in on the exhale. The last minute out of our nose. And relax. Awesome job. So, once again, these movements we're doing for 1 minute, okay? The idea is to go at your own pace, get comfortable with being stable, allowing your breath to be in sync with your body movements, okay? This is a more relaxed class and really giving us the opportunity to go at our own pace, once again, all right? The breathing, we want to be able to exhale and draw our belly button in. As we inhale, we're filling our belly up like a balloon to recover, okay? We're breathing in more of a horizontal plane versus up and down through our chest, okay? Everything's coming from the diaphragm, all right? Awesome job. Hope you guys enjoyed. See you guys next time.